Well, now to the bushfire crisis in East Gippsland and the Alpine region. Tonight, there are three main areas of concern. An emergency warning is in place for Swifts Creek, Brookvale and Ensay, with people there under immediate threat. In the High Country, emergency warnings have been issued for Bright, Hotham, Dinner Plains and the King Valley. Evacuate now orders are also in effect for a significant part of the region. Emergency warnings have also been reissued for Buchan and Buchan South. Emergency services gave this update just moments ago.
With the increased winds, the northerly winds, the dry condition, the higher temperatures, we're seeing increased fire activity. It will happen for the next couple of hours as the change comes through, but as I mentioned previously, we cannot afford to rest in relation to this. We need to remain vigilant because it is on the change.
The change will be unstable. There'll be high winds, particularly in that northeast and alpine country. We'll see very erratic fire activity, and these next few hours are going to be very, very challenging.
Okay, let's go to Bright now, where residents have been urged to evacuate as the flames there rage out of control. Stephanie Anderson joins me live. Steph, the tourist town is all but deserted.
It absolutely is, Alicia. Take a look around. I'm on the main street of Bright and there are very few cars left behind. Most of the shops haven't actually opened today. In fact, the Woolworths supermarket shut its doors at 4 o'clock this afternoon due to this bushfire emergency. Now, all day we have heard from authorities that between 4 and 7 was going to be the danger period, and it certainly has been. We've seen the southwesterly change move in. Have a look at these pictures that we shot just in the last hour off one of the roads leading into Bright. You can see the fire coming over the top of Mount Buffalo straight towards this tourist town. Now, as you say, there's an emergency warning in place for Bright and other areas in the Alpine region. We are being warned that there could be fire impact on these towns within the coming hours. There's more than 200 firefighters out across this area today, and they've certainly had their work cut out for them. Surrounded by a ring of fire retardant to keep it standing, the historic Mount Buffalo Chalet that stood since 1910, today protected by strike crews against the threat of looming flames.
The chalet is a really important asset for our community. What I've experienced over my time here is that everyone who's been to the chalet has a connection and has a story.
On another day of extreme conditions, all hands are on deck. The fight against these raging bushfires coordinated from the air and the ground.
They'll just tie in with the SES, the CFA, and perform any kind of support task that is required of them in those locations.
Residents in Carbor, northwest of Bright, were urged to leave, but Janet Mitchell and daughter Rachel stayed to ensure their fireys were fed.
If everybody leaves, there's no one to put the fire out.
Forest firefighter Ralph Crisper had a rest day from duties on the front line, but spent it preparing his own property in Cheshunt.
We've just got sprinklers going from our grey water pond, so it's keeping it green enough that if we do get some embers over this side, it'll hopefully help.
The wind threat will continue into tonight as authorities look to an even bigger risk ahead.
These fires are likely, with a long bushfire season ahead, to possibly join up with those fires in East Gippsland and also those in southeast New South Wales.
Yet another challenge for exhausted communities who've already endured so much.
This year it's been testing.
It's a lot for everyone here, isn't it?
Yeah.
In the Ovens Valley, Stephanie Anderson, 9 News.
Well, powerful winds meantime are set to supercharge the large number of outbreaks burning in East Gippsland tonight, with several communities in the line of fire. Reid Butler is in Swifts Creek. Reid, what are the conditions like there?
There are about 30 fires burning right now across East Gippsland, Alicia. An emergency warning is in place for where I am, Swifts Creek. There is a fire burning about 5 kilometres to the south of here, and it's feared that this southwesterly wind change that we're just starting to feel come through right now will turbocharge those flames and push them right towards Swifts Creek. It's also feared that wind change would also affect a blaze burning to the northwest of Omeo and push those flames towards that town. Firefighters have been told in that town to prioritise critical infrastructure today, like phone exchanges and the local hospital. So far, conditions have been relatively favourable, but that could change dramatically over the next hour.
Under an angry red Omeo sun, CFA crews prepare for a fresh onslaught of fire hell. But as northerly winds intensified blazes around the town, Sandy Beltrami has defied orders to leave, determined to defend the caravan park she's owned for 12 years.
When everything is on fire, I will hop in my car and I will drive away.
We fought it in 2003 fires. We're in a different house this time and it's a lot smaller. So between my sons, my daughter-in-law and myself, I think we can pretty prepared.
Other Omeo residents who chose not to leave gathering at the town's relief centre, the footy ground a green oasis in an otherwise tinder dry landscape. This was the fire front south of Buchan during round one. Tonight, the town is under threat again, with out-of-control fires raging to the north and the south of the already devastated community.
Let the firefighters do their job, and then we'll get communities back in as soon as possible.
In Swifts Creek, the day started early with a briefing.
But there is certainly still a lot of bush out there to burn. So that's what we're really focused on today, is those areas of bush that are still burning around communities.
Military personnel and firefighters transforming the recreational reserve into base camp.
If we're told to leave, we will leave, but while we're here, we're going to support as much as we can.
The CFA will have help. This is the US Task Force. More than 40 firefighters from across the United States here in East Gippsland to help battle these blazes.
Phoenix, Arizona.
Phoenix.
And I'm from McCall, Idaho.
Support that's never been more welcome from a side needing all the backup it can get. In Swifts Creek, Reid Butler, 9 News.